Today we're going to talk about how to respond to an IRS letter, also known as letter 6323. Well, here's three things not to do. Don't disregard the letter. The revenue agent or the auditor assigned to your case, if they don't receive a communication within 10 days, they could potentially close your case and assess you additional taxes. Second thing not to do. Don't refuse to give information to the IRS, any documents, bank statements, canceled checks, things like that. Failure to do that will, basically the IRS will contact the bank directly and summons your records, and they might even contact neighbors and business associates. Third thing not to do, don't modify any records, don't create any records. If you have an invoice that's listed on your tax return as an expense, don't create it because now you don't have it. Those type of activities could be deemed fraudulent activities and your case could be referred to IRS Criminal Investigation Division without your knowledge. Lastly, don't give the wrong information to IRS. If you don't give the correct information, it could expand the audit to new tax years and additional issues that originally were not looked at by IRS. Well, let's talk about three things that you should do. Number one, contact the revenue agent and review the letter. The letter will identify three important pieces of information, the revenue agent's name and telephone number, the tax year, so you know which tax return to pull and what documents that are needed to substantiate the tax return. And the third piece of information that's on that letter is the taxpayer. It's either going to be you as an individual, your company if you own a business, or potentially both. Once you review the letter, contact the IRS and set an appointment and start gathering your records. You're going to need your bank statements, your canceled checks, your deposit items. Now, why are deposit items important? Well, if you have a lot of cash deposits or if you have a lot of checks that have been deposited, your bank statements may not reflect the check number or who paid you the check that you now deposited. You're going to need to get that information. Some of those deposits may not be income, things that are not income, insurance claim reimbursements, reimbursement checks from certain people, and transfers between bank accounts. And you might have notes as to that, so you'll need that information pretty quickly. Last thing that you'll need to do is you'll need to review your tax return. Now, if you find things that are potentially incorrect and you've identified some mistakes, you're gonna need to contact a tax attorney, a qualified tax attorney, to go through and minimize your risks. If you don't do that ahead of time, you simply give information to the IRS, and IRS then comes to you and identifies that, it's gonna be a little bit harder to explain that after the fact and after IRS has already identified it, because it's all about credibility. That first contact with the IRS and the first bit of information you give, it needs to show that you have complete information and that the information you're providing is credible, not manufactured, not made up. I'm John Milikowsky, founder of Milikowsky Tax Law. Our law firm has had over 300 audits, civil and criminal audits with IRS and State of California tax agencies. We support businesses and we're here to help.